Listening Library presents The Underdogs Catch a Cat Burglar by Kate and Joel Temple. Read for you by Alexandra Ryan. Note to listeners, this audiobook includes a downloadable PDF containing activities from the printed book. Chapter 1. Let me tell you how many cats there used to be in the Underdog Detective Agency. Zero. Zilch. Not one. Then along came Fang. One eye, three teeth, a kink in her tail. You wouldn't pick her as a Dogtown detective, would you? Hi there!
Fang, tabby cat, wants to be a detective. Loves sardines.
For starters, she's not a dog. She's a cat. Yes, yes, I know what you're thinking. What's a cat even doing in Dogtown? Well, there are lots of different animals living in Dogtown. True, it's mostly dogs, but there are always exceptions. Fang is one of them. Welcome to Dogtown. Population, 1 million canine. You see, Fang grew up in Dogtown. A strange place for a cat to grow up. But Fang's parents taught cat at the local school, so Dogtown is all she ever knew. How to speak cat. Purr. Hiss.
How do you spell meow?
At school, her dog friend showed her all the local customs. How to bark at the door.
Woof woof. Bark, bark.
How to chase balls. How to whiz on trees. Step one, lift leg. Step two, pee. Fang's dog friends did all these things very well, and Fang did them all very badly. Her bark was a meow.
Bark, bark, bark.
Meow.
She got bored of chasing the same stupid ball. And the idea of whizzing on trees seemed gross and very embarrassing. Yuck! When school finished, everyone went off to get jobs in Dogtown, including Fang. She tried her paw as a sheepdog, but the sheep took no notice of her. Bah. She put up her tail to work in the ski resorts with the huskies, but she kept falling down. She spent a week as a ball girl at the tennis club, but the Jack Russells just shook their heads. She even tried out as an official butt sniffer.
Ugh.
Her parents suggested she try something less doggish, like a curtain installer.
Rip.
But that didn't work out either. Fang knew there had to be something she was good at, but what? What Fang needed was a sign.
Hey, a sign!
Do you have what it takes to be an underdog detective? Fang went inside. It didn't look much like a detective agency. It looked like a soup factory. Wait a minute. It was a soup factory. There was a conveyor belt with lots of cans going around on it and a big bubbly pot of something that smelled disgusting. Hello? Is this where I become a dog detective? Asked Fang. A gruff-looking terrier answered her. No, this is McTavish's soup factory. I'm Mrs. McTavish. Fang crinkled her nose.
What's that terrible smell? That's my famous Brussels sprout and blue cheese soup,
barked Mrs. McTavish.
If you're looking for the Underdog Detective Agency, it's upstairs.
She pointed to a rickety staircase, and Fang followed it upstairs. She was happy to get away from the stench. Hello? Called Fang. Is this where I become a dog detective? A chihuahua in sunglasses and a Hawaiian shirt looked up from the front desk and immediately started laughing.
Detective Barkley, there's a cat here who wants to be a dog detective.
Carl, chihuahua, wearer of Hawaiian shirts, occasional answerer of phones.
Chapter 2. This is Detective Barkley. He's a German shepherd. Most German shepherds join the police force. Not Barkley. Sirens make him howl.
Barkley, German shepherd. Looks good in a trench coat. Bushy eyebrows.
Okay, Carl, knock off the gags. Barked Detective Barkley. Barkley looked Fang up and down. Are you delivering fish heads? The soup factory is downstairs.
I'm not delivering anything, replied Fang. I'm here about the job.
You are? You know this is a detective agency.
Sure.
We're not some cat cafe. Barkley frowned. We're detectives. We go undercover to investigate mysteries and solve crimes.
That's what I want to do, said Fang.
Barkley raised one bushy eyebrow. You want to go undercover to investigate mysteries and solve crimes?
Yes, she did.
Okay, then. Can you sniff?
Naturally.
Can you jump?
How high?
What about climbing?
Better than a monkey.
Got sharp teeth?
My name's Fang.
Okay, Barkley said. But how do you feel about wearing a disguise? Cats hate dressing up.
Fang reached into her pocket. I'm fine with it. Ta-da!
Barkley couldn't quite put his paw on it, but he knew there was something he liked about Fang. And having a cat on the team might actually be a good idea. No one would ever suspect she was an undercover dog detective. Have you ever heard of the cat burglar? Growled Barkley. Everyone had heard of the cat burglar, even Fang. The cat burglar had stolen everything in Dogtown, from handbags to ham sandwiches. Nobody had been able to catch him.
Barkley tapped his foot as he thought.
Why not use a cat to catch the cat burglar? It's so absurd, it just might work. Congratulations, cat. I can't believe I'm saying this, but I'm giving you a shot. We need all the help we can get right now, said Barkley.
Fang grinned. I can be very persuasive.
When do I start? At that exact moment, the phone rang. Carl the Chihuahua receptionist looked at it in surprise. Ring, ring. Ah! What's the phone doing? Yelped Carl.
I think it's ringing, offered Fang helpfully.
Oh, ringing, said Carl. That's right. I forgot phones did that. Well, are you going to answer it? Asked Barkley. Carl picked up the phone. Hello? This is the... Wait a minute. What are we called again? Barkley grabbed the phone from Carl. Oh, for dog's sake. Hello, this is the Underdog Detective Agency. No clue left undug. The voice on the other end of the phone was loud. The cat burglar has struck again! Barkley turned to Fang. How about starting right now? Chapter 3. Fang couldn't believe it. She was an underdog. As she looked around the Underdog Detective Agency, she could see there was another dog in the corner of the office. It wasn't hard to spot her because she was covered in spots. It wasn't chicken pox or even dog pox. She was a Dalmatian.
Dr. Spots, Dalmatian, inventor of things that don't always work.
This is Dr. Spots. She's got a gadget for everything. Dr. Spots, this is Fang, our new underdog detective, said Barkley.
That's a brilliant cat costume. I almost thought you were a cat,
laughed Dr. Spots.
I am a cat,
said Fang. Dr. Spots gasped.
What?
Barkley looked at her. Fang is the only one who applied for the job, Spots. I'm sure she'll be all right once we show her the ropes.
I love rope, said Fang.
There's no rope, grumbled Barkley. It's just a saying.
Oh, I knew that.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.